The calculated data function in Pi data link allows you to do quick, basic calculations, things like taking the maximum, the minimum, over a time range for a tag. So what I have here is I have some Pi tag, CDT158 in this case, and what I've done over here is I've asked, I want to know what was the daily maximum every day for a week. And we can see there's every day is represented here, and then at a different time each day, calculated data has found the maximum. And over here, this is an example of what I might try to do if I wasn't going to use calculated data. So what I might do is I would use a compressed data query. So this is a compressed data query right here to just bring in all the raw values for this tag over this week. And you'll see that now I have 1700 values on my sheet. And you can imagine if I started to do this for maybe 20 tags all at once, this could be a lot of data on my sheet. It's going to make my sheet bigger. It's going to take it longer to load. It's the performance as far as interacting with the Pi server is going to be lower. And also, if I want to know what was the maximum value over this week, in Excel, I can ask for it using the max function. That works, but there's one limitation with it. It'll give me the maximum, but it's more difficult to find out exactly when this maximum happened in this list of data. The thing is, a lot of Excel functions are extremely powerful, but they're not built around the idea that you have time-based data, whereas all the Pi system calculations underneath calculated data are built around the assumption that you have time-based data. So I can very quickly do the same calculation with calculated data that I'm doing right there with Excel right away in one cell. So in one cell, I can know when the maximum was, what it was, and I don't need to have 1700 values on my sheet, and I get to know exactly what time this maximum happened really easily, really painlessly. So that's what we're going to see right now. So I'm just going to delete all this so you can get a sense of what I'm doing here. And it starts off with, I'll just delete this too. I want to know what's the daily maximum, and we'll see some other calculated data queries. And first I need to know what data item I'm after, so I'll search. And I'll go into my Pi server and I'll search for a Pi tag. And I find it and I'll just click OK. It gets a go res right there. And the start time, well, I'm interested in what's happening over the last week. So T minus 7D. So today minus 7 days from now. Till today. So this morning at midnight. And then what's the daily maximum? So the raw values, well, we saw how to do that. That's just with compressed data. But what we're interested in is what to do with calculated data. So I'll just click on calculated data here. And then it asks for much the same thing. So data item, that's going to be the data item. The start time will be the start time. The end time will be the end time here. So I click in data item field. I click on my data item, B2. Click on start time. Click on my start time, B3. Click on end time field. Click in B4 right there. Now the time interval, that's going to be how often do I want this interval to be. So I'm asking for the daily maximum. So I'm going to type in 1D for one day. I could also put this on my sheet and just refer to that, but I'm just going to type it in this field here. And then I need to say what calculation mode I want. Well, I'm interested in a maximum. So I'm going to select maximum from that drop-down menu there. And I'll say apply. And I get a number of maximums. Now I'm interested in what time did these maximums happen at? So I can click on show min or max time. And now I can see the time at which this maximum happened. And I could if I were to show start time and end time, this shows me the start time of this the frame that I'm looking at. Which day am I looking at to see the maximum? And when did that day end? So this is basically the 11th of March is this row. And then the 12th of March is this row, and the 13th of March is this row. And on the 11th of March, at 6:53 a.m., the maximum for the entire day happened, right there. Now, if I want to see other calculated data data items, I can put those in really easily. So this is the maximum. What if I wanted to know the minimum and maybe the what other options do I have here? The range, so maybe the range from maximum to minimum, so the range. We can ask for different calculations that we want. And all it takes is we'll take a calculated data query, click in calculated data, get a fresh calculated data query, and link it up in much the same way. So I click in data item, click here, click on start time, click on my start time field B3, end time, click on B4, time interval, that's 1 day again, 1D. And I'm going to say minimum. And I'll say apply. And I get the minimum for those days. And if I want the range, all I need to do, well, I could go through the same wizard that works, or I can just take this field here, copy it, and paste it. And now I have two calculated data queries, and all I need to do now is just change this to the range. There. So I have the range that this tag went over. And if you want to check this, I could just say the range is equal to this cell minus this cell. Scroll this down, you can see that the range is being calculated correctly. With calculated data, you can very easily do all of these calculations on the Pi server. So you don't need to have your spreadsheet filled and filled and filled with lots of raw values that then you're doing calculations with Excel calculations on. It can all be done on the Pi server, which will be faster. You'll have a lighter weight spreadsheet. You can do all sorts of powerful time range calculations, things that aren't available to you in the standard Excel functions.